Good evening, and what's going on? This is your cousin Dave, and you must be part of the in crowd, because this is, it's called jazz. And for the next couple hours, we're going to be listening to some of the best jazz out there. The classics. Including folks like Ramsey Lewis and his wonderful tune, The In Crowd. Let's listen to a little bit more of that before we get into it. Let's get into the groove. Once again, good evening. This is your cousin Dave, and it's called jazz. And I hope you're going to enjoy the next little bit of music we're going to have. Once again, that was Ramsey Lewis. And I want to give you a little background about this tune. It comes from an album called The In Crowd. And it was recorded in 1965 at the Bohemian Caverns, a nightclub in Washington, D.C., and they recorded an entire album there from May 13th, 14th, and 15th of 1965. And in 1966, the album won for the best instrumental jazz performance by an individual or a group. And so that's a little background history on that tune. And the reason I'm mentioning it right now is we're going to end this podcast tonight with a song from The In Crowd album. You've heard this intro over and over since the show started. You might as well hear one more tune off that album. But anyway, I hope you're in the mood for some good jazz. And let's see here if anything I need to tell you. Oh, yes, I want to tell you a little quick story for those who listen to the blues podcast. I have a cousin who is a faithful listener to Why the Blues, and he listens to it every Tuesday. I don't know if I think he waits till later on and listens to it in his leisure. The beauty of podcasts. You don't have to listen to it live, although it's wonderful if you do. And if you got some comments tonight, please give me some. I would love to hear from you. But anyway, my cousin left a comment, and that's why comments are so valuable, because sometimes I make a mistake or something's going on and I am not aware of it. Well, anybody who's been listening to me for a while knows about my black cat, Sam. As a matter of fact, the cat went through quite an ordeal December and January. He hadn't have an operation. But he's fit as a fiddle now. So fit that he likes to jump up on my desk where I have my monitor. And, of course, it's connected to my desktop. And this is where I record this show. And anyway, he was on top of the desk, and I was trying to get him off. And inadvertently, he knocked off the webcam, which contains the speaker. So my cousin mentioned, I was having trouble listening to you. And and he said, I had to really turn it up every time you spoke. Well, I wondered what that was all about. So I came back to this room where this desktop is and noticed that the speaker was gone. And it turns out Sam had knocked it loose. I hadn't noticed. And so a great deal of the podcast was done with the speaker on the ground, or the mic, not the speaker, excuse me. So anyway, I want to apologize to everybody who was listening to it that day, but it's rather funny. Sam, I can't get mad at him. He's my buddy, and he's one of the friendliest little critters I've ever come across, so I would never get mad. But yeah, he had a little mishap, and it's funny now, but at the time, I'm scratching my head, like, why couldn't my cousin hear me well? That was the reason. The mic was on the ground. Anyway, let's get going with the show. Enough of my explanation for what happened with that. And I've got an idea of a couple artists I'm going to play in a row. And I'm going to first start off with some Ella Fitzgearld. And she's going to sing couple tunes from an album she did several years ago where she did the Gershwin Songbook. Of course, that would be George Gershwin, who wrote the melodies, and Ira Gershwin, who wrote the lyrics. And there's an old saying, do you love them? It's not exactly like this, I'm paraphrasing it, but basically something to the fact, don't you love a Gershwin tune? And I surely do. And Ella does a great job on this. She recorded five albums of Gershwin's music in 1959, and she was backed by the Nelson Riddle Orchestra. And it was the first time that they had recorded together. Nelson Riddle had recorded with quite a few great artists, and this was the first time that they had recorded with Ella. So let's start off with this Gershwin tune, and we will follow it by another one. The first tune for this evening is Fascinating Rhythm by Ella Fitzgearld.
Got a little rhythm, a rhythm, a rhythm that pitter-pats through my brain. So darn persistent, the day isn't distant when it'll drive me insane. Comes in the morning without any warning and hangs around me all day. I'll have to sneak up to it someday and speak up to it. I hope it listens when I say, fascinating rhythm, you've got me on the go. Fascinating rhythm, I'm all a quiver. What a mess you're making, the neighbors want to know why I'm always shaking just like a flivver. Each morning I get up with the sun, start a hopping, never stopping, to find at night no work has been done. I know that once it didn't matter, but now you're doing wrong when you start to patter. I'm so unhappy. Won't you take a day off, decide to run along somewhere far away off and make it snappy. Oh, how I long to be the gal I used to be. Fascinating rhythm, oh won't you stop picking on me. So unhappy. Won't you take a day off, decide to run along somewhere far away off and make it snappy. Oh, how I long to be the gal I used to be. Fascinating rhythm, fascinating rhythm. That love is blind, still we're often told, seek and you shall find. So I'm going to seek a certain lad I've had in mind. Looking everywhere, haven't found him yet. He's the big affair I cannot forget. Only man I